There's the Wright brothers, there's the jet engine, and now we're doing flying taxis. No, really, this stuff is real.
Vehicles that we're seeing now in the forms of prototypes and mock-ups, they incorporate a lot of, you know, new technology that makes this possible.
Honeywell understands the digital integration of not just the avionics and the front end with the pilot sees, but it's digital all the way back. It's all computer and digitally controlled, and that's Honeywell's forte.
Our FlyByOurComputer is based on modern electronics that's very powerful microprocessors, but also it's designed to be safe and redundant. So three of our computers flying the airplane, if one or even two of those computers fails, the third one can still fly the aircraft and really fly it without the pilot having to take over or the pilot having to perform heroics or save the day. The aircraft will fly with the same handling characteristics and be easy to fly even after failure.
The same technologies that are helping spur self-driving cars, thinking about automation, thinking about technologies that are going to go on both, we're seeing a lot of, or at least I see a lot of cross-fertilization. And in some ways, I feel like the aviation folks have been sneaking up on us in the transportation community. That, you know, this is great with the self-driving cars, but we've forgotten that there's a third dimension of air that might beat us to it.
The other software system is detect and avoid. It's providing the eyes to the aircraft so it can avoid other aircraft, it can avoid birds, it can avoid obstacles on the ground. It can actually help the aircraft in automated ways see better than even pilots can see.
The name of the game and the success of these vehicles, so that we can all ride it, so that it's not the luxury item, is in automation, is in autonomous operations. So the challenge is definitely out there, and it will take the best teams to crunch through it.